You in library.
Very good, sir.
Winston bows slightly and leaves room. Bye, Winston! Alright, so let's examine the, look at it. There's a small hole in the crest where the dragon's eyes should be. The hole looks like shaped like a miniature shield. Oh, that's convenient. Unlock dragon design with locket. Haha. You hold shell's locket up to the dragon's eye and push. You can feel it click into place. Convenient hole in the wall. Suddenly, the panel below the crest opens to reveal a secret passage.
Jack, you did it. I've got the supplies. So that's why my locket was so important. It opens the secret passage. Let's get out of here before my father finds out.
Yeah. Together you move into the secret passage. You shut the panel behind you as Shella lights a lantern. Shella hands you the equipment she brought with her. You sneak through the dusty, narrow corridors that run along the walls of the mansion. They lead to a carefully constructed underground passageway. You travel for a long distance in a stuffy, dark shaft. At last, you reach the end of the passage. A huge stone door blocks the way out. With Shella's help, you shove the door open and walk out into the forest. Behind you, the door closes into the huge rock from which it was carved. No amount of effort will open the door from this side.
I know where we are from here. Let's go.
Huh. Well, son of a gun.
I recognize this area. The road to Tyrsis is west of here. We can follow it all the way there.
Okay, let's go. Actually, we click on this shit. I recognize this road. We were on it once before. Monsters. Nope, screw off.
The ferry crosses the river near here. It's the only way to ford the Rappahalodron at this point.
Yeah. Oh, not you again. You walk out of the forest down towards the ferry crossing on the Rappahalodron River. You are greatly surprised to see someone standing in your way.
What are you doing here?
Waiting for the ferry.
Yeah. What is this all about? Let's talk to you. Let's see. Why did you murder the herbalist?
Fools. In the name of my master, Brona, I will destroy you both. Attack!
You son of a bitch. Alright, we're back in our battle scene now.
Destroy them both.
Both. Alright, so you can't really do any damage to the gardener, at least as far as I know. All crazy like death. You can give orders for each of your party members. So you can say, just attack the closest. Actually, let's not do that. Ignore the leader. And then I'm going to attack. And you click on each one, and that'll be your target.
Take that, bastard!
Attack. Piss off. Oh, that hurt. Now he'll leave.
When we meet again, you will die.
It's Kano.
He just disappeared.
Yeah, what a shifty little bastard. Well, anyway, let's continue on. We have to cross the river, and I don't know what to do. Look at the dock. Ferry docks are crudely constructed, but look sound. Look at the rope. See a solid wood wheel bobbing in the current. A rope tied to it from the far dock has kept it from floating away downriver. Okay. No, we don't want to get the river. We don't want to enter the river. Rope? Take rope? The rope and pulley are too far from the shore for you to reach them. So let's use the fishing pole. Catch the rope with fishing pole. Cast the line to the river several times before you finally manage to snag the rope and pulley and pull them into shore.
You've got it. Now let's fix this ferry.
Yeah, so now the ferry's on the other side. So, we have to release the brake, and we have nothing that we can throw at it. Although we do have significant amounts of items now. If we click on Shella on her item bag, we can see that she has some stuff. So if we say, Shella, shoot the bow at the break.
That's an easy shot for me.
Shella casually pulls back her bow and takes aim. Her arrow flies straight and true across the river and releases the ferry break.
There!
You pull the ferry easily over to your side of the river as you board the ferry and start to haul your way across the swift waters of the Rappahannock River. Shella watches the bank behind you.
Jack! Monsters! They're coming out from the woods! Hurry!
With all your strength, you pull on the pulley rope while Shella holds the monsters off with arrows. As you climb off, you can feel the ferry lurch as a huge creature on the far side tries to pull it back. With your sword, you slash the ferry rope. The ferry floats off downriver.
At least that should slow down Brona's monsters. We can send someone from Tyrsis to fix it later.
Together, you set off on the road to Tyrsis. That would be assuming that you actually got off at the right spot.
The road to Tyrsis leads northward, then cuts east as we climb up the hills to Tyrsis.
Okay. Follow the road. Monsters, oh god.
Look up there on the cliffside. You can see the fortress walls. We'll be there by dark.
Yeah.
We need to follow the road upward. The mountain cliffs around here are pretty steep.
Are they? There's monsters there. I don't like this. Hello. Party on Stone Wrap. Holy crap. You approach the fabled city of Tyrsis, built upon a high plateau and protected by sheer cliffs to the south. It has stood as an impenetrable fortress for centuries. As you climb up the immense stone and iron rampway that rises to the gates of Tyrsis, you remember the stories your father and uncle told you of Balinor and Minyan defending the city against Brona's army. Shella is equally quiet and looks as though she too is remembering tales of her father. The ramparts of the fortress are lined with torches. You can see figures moving around the outer wall. Nearing the city gate, you pause as the odor of decay assails your nose, and a chill runs through your body. Holy shit!
What's going on here? Those aren't people. They're corpses. Walking corpses are trying to get into Tyrsis.
Oh no!
Guard! Guard!
Who's out there? Announce yourself!
Princess Shella of Lee and Jack Olmsford.
Well, your highnesses, you better go find some safe place to hide. You can't get in here while these monsters are around.
You can do your job.
What should we do? We can't just stand here waiting for dawn. The monsters will catch up to us. We've got to get into the city.
Son of a bitch. Alright, well, this looks like a good time to cut off for now, so I'm gonna save. When we come back, we'll figure out what to do about these corpses and get into the city. I'll see y'all later.